Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Apple Watch Series 3. Released in 2017, it was Apple's first cellular-enabled smartwatch. Fast forward a year later, Apple introduces the Series 4. Now, the Series 4 is a nice improvement, but if you want to buy an Apple Watch, you may want to consider the Series 3. How's it going, everybody? I am Jason with the Review Suite, and these are three reasons why you should buy the Apple Watch Series 3 in 2018. Before you go out and purchase a smartwatch, it's important to know that there are a lot of options to choose from. Some offer more or less features than others, so it's important for you to know what you want out of your smartwatch. If you already own an iPhone, the Apple Watch is obviously the best smartwatch you can buy. With that said, let's get into the list with number three, watchOS. WatchOS runs on every series Apple Watch. Not the first generation, but every Apple Watch thereafter. Yeah, anyway, with watchOS 5, you get features such as activity competitions, Apple Podcasts, and of course, walkie-talkie.
Hey, babe.
Now, of course, watchOS runs faster on the newest hardware, but the experience is just the same on the Apple Watch Series 3. And speaking of hardware, let's talk about the specs. Apple Watch Series 3 is impressive for any premium smartwatch, and it's only second to the Series 4 in that class. For fitness, the Series 3 has GPS, barometric altimeter, and is water resistant up to 50 meters. You also have Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 4.2, and 8 gigabytes of storage. All of this is powered by the S3 dual core chip.
Hey Siri, what time is it in New Delhi?
In New Delhi, India, it's 11:10 p.m.
Hey Siri, did North Carolina Central win the football game yesterday?
NC Central soundly defeated Edward Waters by a score of 52-12 yesterday.
And because the Series 3 is only a year old, you definitely want to consider the prices. Based on the starting prices, the 38mm Series 3 costs $120 less than the 40mm Series 4, and every cellular model is $100 more than the non-cellular models. Now you may be saying to yourself, $120 isn't a huge difference, but think about what you could do with that $120. You could purchase a one-year subscription of Apple Music, or you could buy yourself a pair of Beats X earbuds. But hey, in the end, it's your money. The Series 3 and 4 are some of the best smartwatches on the market, but I wouldn't dismiss the Series 3 because it's older. It being last year's model, we should expect watchOS support for at least the next few years. If you do not have a need for the electrical heart sensor and fall detection, I would definitely go with the Series 3. Of course, you can save a few bucks if you buy refurbished or used, but the prices are kind of all over the place, especially on eBay and Amazon. So just keep an eye out for the model you want and try to find the lowest possible price throughout the web. But that's going to do it for me, everyone. Let us know in the comments down below, what do you think about the Apple Watch Series 3? Do you love it? Do you hate it? And what smartwatches do you use or recommend? If you found this video useful, please hit that like button and maybe consider subscribing to the Review Suite. I'm Jason, and I'll talk to you guys on the next one.